the 15th of December. You're with AIM. It's wonderful to have your company this morning. That beautiful singing you've just heard is the New Zealand Children's Choral Academy. Give it up. Wonderful. So wonderful to have you in our studio this morning. Thank you so much for being with us, and we're going to hear a lot more from you throughout the show. So that's very exciting.
Very cool.
And lovely to see you both this morning.
It's the last show.
It's the last show. Before Christmas.
Last show for the year.
Yeah, last show for the year. My last show. And what I decided, just as a little sort of... I can't swear.
You can't usually anyway.
I know you're not meant to, but we do sometimes. But there's children in here. But anyway, they always told me since I started the show that I could never... I always had to do the top button up. So today...
Whoa!
Hey. Just a little Christmas treat for the ladies and the men out there.
So you just enjoy that throughout the next 3 hours. All right, it is 6 o'clock. We've got a lot coming up on the show this morning. The numbers have been crunched and the results are in. The FIFA Women's World Cup has netted New Zealand more than $100 million and is set to supercharge the game for years to come. We have more on this developing story this morning after news.
Get ready for chaos at the airports. More than 1.7 million Kiwis will take to the skies this holiday season. We'll have more on preparations for that at 6:50.
And we wish the Prime Minister a Merry Christmas after 7. Plus, we get our political panel to reflect on the year that was and name their politician of the year, a winner and a loser. That's at 7:05.
And we catch up with superweight celebrity Patches the Cat. Celebrate Christmas with our wonderful choir on this, our final show of 2023. Right now, though, here's Nikki with your news.
Good morning. It's a festive 6 o'clock. Hosting the Women's FIFA World Cup far exceeded expectations, generating nearly $110 million of economic benefit for the country. A new report. 5 minutes after six, people.
Thank you very much, Nikki. So, as you can see, we're mixing our news headlines, your latest news this morning, with some Christmas festivity to get you in the mood for the holiday season. You know that our set has been transformed into a Christmas wonderland, and that has been thanks to our partners at Farmers. Today is the last day of our special Christmas shopping competition. We've asked you to tell us how you'd make Christmas special with a Farmers voucher. And you've been able to go on the draw to be our daily gifting tree winner to win a voucher worth up to $500. Now, Ryan, would you like to announce our last winner of this competition?
I would. I'm going to pretend for a moment that I don't know where it is, but I know it's here. And why. This is our final card. So I don't know if anybody has actually been behind the scenes, you know, deciding where these go, but surely they'd end on a high note.
surely.
Wow, the suspense.
It's going to be a little disappointing if they don't. But congratulations, a $300 Farmers gift card is coming your way. Today's winner is Andrea Hope from Invercargill, and she says, I would give it to my gorgeous friend Mel, who has had a rubbish year.
Aww.
Not you. This included needing eye surgery to save her eyesight. She is the most caring and wonderful person, and it would be so nice if something good happened to her for a change. So congratulations. This gift card is coming to you from Farmers.
Well done. Andrea Hope giving it to her friend Mel. It's 7 minutes past six. Lots more to come right now. Let's take a look at the weather.
The weather, brought to you by Nature. Turn it to power by Meridian.
There's warm and humid conditions about the west of the South Island, but mainly fine for the North Island. The lower south end is partly cloudy with a few showers, northerlies turning southerly in the afternoon. 25 degrees for you, Dunedin. It's partly cloudy and rain developing in the afternoon for the west coast, nor'easterlies, and 18 degrees for Westport. The Canterbury and Marlborough regions are partly cloudy with nor'easterlies. Christchurch, you're heading for a very warm 26 today. The lower north, well, you can expect a mostly cloudy day with a few northerly breezes. Wellington will top just 18 degrees. And it's a fine day ahead for the central plateau. Apart from a little bit of morning cloud and nor'westerly winds, 21 is the high for Taupo. Over on the east coast, it's also fine, apart from some early morning cloud and nor'westerly breezes. A lovely 25 degrees ahead for you, Napier. And the top of Aotearoa, cloudy with a chance of a shower and westerly winds. Auckland, 22 degrees for you. OK, and let's take a quick look at the weather over the weekend, or not. Well, maybe we won't. It's not there, so we won't take a look at that. We'll move along.
We'll save that for later, 8 minutes past six. Now, $109.5 million, that's how much the FIFA Women's World Cup delivered to New Zealand. We all wondered, how much is this going to impact our economy? And the impact evaluation report has been released today. It reveals that 744,236 tickets were sold and nearly 60% of Kiwis watched a game. So, in short, the report says it's been a huge success and women's football is set to reap the rewards for years to come. Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment New Zealand Manager Kylie Hawker-Green joins us now. Good morning, Kylie.
Amorena.
So, Kylie, in terms of every dollar that we spent on this tour around the world and what that is going to do for the sport, 16 past six, thank you so much for your time this morning. Ministry of Business, Innovation and Employment New Zealand Manager of Events, Kylie Hawker-Green.
You're watching AM's 2023 Christmas special. This is our last day on air today. And if you have a message that you'd like to send through to the show, to us, we would love to read it out on air this morning. Get in touch. Feedback at amshow.co.nz. It can be your best moment of your life this year, the best moment of the show this year, or your best politician, worst politician, whatever you want to do.
Or a wee message to Ryan, because, of course, we are coming back as AM next year, but this is Ryan's last show.
It is. Feedback at amshow.co.nz. Coming up next, Hollywood's biggest winners and losers for the year. Entertainment correspondent Nelson Aspin is with us live after the break. Welcome back to AM. This is a Christmas special. You are watching the New Zealand Children's Choral Academy singing beautifully for us this morning, and they'll be here all morning. Just gone 20 after six. We're also going to New York right now. Taylor Swift has celebrated her 34th birthday. She's only 34, I know, and she's on the cover of Time magazine, but some people are living their lives, aren't they? She has had a big birthday bash in New York City, and right there is our US entertainment correspondent, Nelson Aspin. Well, he's not quite at the party. Nelson, good morning.
yeah, I
That's what happens.
Right. A lot about you behind your back.
Not even behind his back.
No, actually, that's a good point.
The holiday season is well and truly here at 27 minutes past six. More than a million Kiwis are expected to take to the air this summer. So how can you best avoid airport chaos? We'll find out more about that after news. Thank you so much for being with us this Friday morning, our final AM show of the year. That's Elise Bradley with the New Zealand Children's Choral Academy. Right now, it's time for your news.
Good morning.
And that's the only interview I've had.
Not buying it, Eddie. Anyway, that's the news, the very latest from Newshub.
There's many times that he has spoken and I haven't quite believed what he's said. He's pretty good at the old chat, isn't he, Nikki? Mm-hmm. Now, a lot of you have sent in some lovely messages this morning, Christmas messages and messages for Ryan, because this will be the last time we see him on AM, but of course he will be moving to 7 o'clock in the evening, so you'll be able to see him then. But Dwayne says he's only just found out it's your last day. He says, thank you for being a wonderful host over the last few years, and please undo another button.
Sit down, Dwayne. Maybe later.
Ryan
maybe
has...
one every hour till we get to 9 o'clock.
Dear. How many buttons have you got? That's
what do I do.
You're the most professional, actually.
I don't know about that.
Well, when you're reading your news bulletins. Anyway, thank you. The feedback is great. Keep it coming. Feedback at amshow.co.nz. We do have also some letters of complaint, which I was hoping to read out.
Oh.
I thought we should do it while the kids aren't here.
Oh, are they really complainers?
Well, there might be a few words.
Who's complaining at Christmas time?
No. People who've complained on previous shows.
Oh. Yeah. Oh, I love a complaint.
Yeah, yeah, love
let's
a good complaint.
Okay. Let's get to the weather first, though.
South.
Thanks, Rick. very much, Nikki. We will get to some complaints as well a little later on, but next we're reflecting on 2023's highs, lows and everything in between with Newshub's international correspondent. Stay with us.
Know my heart and my good morning, New Zealand. It is Friday, and this is a live shot of Auckland from the Sky Tower. A high of 21 degrees here today, a low of, well, I'm not sure actually, doesn't say, but there are cloudy periods, some showers clearing, and they will clear by this afternoon. It's 45 minutes from Albany to Manukau, 35 minutes from Bombay to the city. Traffic updates thanks to our partner Battery Zone for all your power needs. Melissa, what are you doing?
Is this enough of a supporting role for you? Am I yes. giving you all the support you need this morning?
I think yes, we've got a little bit of food coming in later, so we'll just sort of hand feed you.
Is that okay?
Yeah.
I'm your biggest fan.
Perhaps I should get some palms and you guys could wave the palms, you know.
I'll whack you in the head with it.
Yeah. All right, joke over. It's 14 away from 7 now. Usually around this time we check in with our Newshub and AM correspondents around the world for the latest headlines. In an AM Christmas special, we're bringing them all together on screen, at least. We have Emma Cropper, Australia correspondent. We've got US correspondent Mitch McCann and Europe correspondent Lisette Raymer. And we have a little surprise for you all at the end, so all do stay together at the end. But I want to ask you first, we'll start with you, Emma, what has been, I guess, maybe one or two of the biggest stories, the most significant stories that have happened in your patch this year?
I think it would definitely be the Warriors, Melissa, the Up the Wars movement.
Oh, that's nice.
And we look forward to seeing you in 2024 as well. It was very nice.
Hey, Mitch, just I've noticed you've been drinking from a cup quite a lot during this cross. What are you drinking?
It's just water, Ryan. I don't think they'll let me bring whiskey in here, but I think I might have one for you guys when I get home. It's only one in the afternoon, though.
Hey, thank you, guys. Thank you so much. And look, I have absolutely loved working with all of you. I think you're all brilliant in your own ways. And just keep doing what you're doing. And keep doing what you're doing next year, obviously. I look forward to seeing you then, maybe at a different time of the day.
We'll miss you, Ryan.
Love that, mate. Merry Christmas to you guys.
Merry Christmas.
We'll miss you, Ryan.
See you later in Sydney, in London and in New York. Those were our correspondents. It's 7 to 7. Just ahead, get ready for chaos at the airports. 1.7 million Kiwis are expected to take to the air this summer. Oh, sounds horrible. Find out how to avoid the queues. Good morning, New Zealand, and Merry Christmas. You're watching AM's Christmas special and final show for 2023. We've got a live choir this morning. They'll be here throughout the morning. Coming up three away from seven now. If you have to travel, Air New Zealand is gearing up for an extremely busy Christmas. More than a million Kiwis will take to the air around New Zealand this holiday season. That's just domestically alone. Another 700,000 are going to be jetting off to international destinations. Lucky them. Friday, this 22nd of December, is going to be the busiest day. That's next Friday. 50,000. Just wear some track pants and some little jandals, please, that you can slip out of. Right, it is 7 o'clock. You're watching AM.
It is Friday the 15th of December. You're watching AM, a very special Christmas show. Coming up, more Christmas joy from our wonderful choir. Plenty of surprises for us and for you.
And we look back at the political highs and lows from 2023 with our political panel. Ginny Anderson and Erica Stanford are here this morning.
Also, last summer was an absolute shocker for many of us. Can we expect better this year? Is the mercury on the rise or will it be a washout? Niwa's Ben Nogg gives us his predictions at 7:20.
And remember Patches the cat? Well, the chubby little fella has lost a lot of weight. He's been on a weight loss program. Yeah, this is the before, I think. So we're going to find out how much he has managed to lose and how much healthier he is. help going into the Christmas season.
And we head to the world's highest post box to make sure Santa gets our Christmas wishes. Stay with us for that right now, though, news.
Good morning, it's 7 o'clock. A person has died. 2026. And that is the very latest from Newshub. It is 7 minutes after seven.
Thanks, Nikki. Now, William is going to be bringing some Christmas surprises for some unsuspecting Kiwis this morning. We're going to cross to him now. What are you up to at the moment, William?
Yeah, morena, Melissa. We're down here at Webb's Auction House in Mount Eden, and they've kindly offered up a ride for us to use. And it's not this. It's right here. It's the red 1962 Ford Thunderbird. We've got Cam in the front. Cam, what have we got?
Oh, yeah.
Welcome back to AM. No, not that we actually left. It was just weather. We got carried away. Anyway, it is 10 minutes after 7 o'clock, and this is our Christmas special. Once an ice cream and deodorant seller, Christopher Luxon, did you know that?
I didn't know that.
Has gone from boardroom to Prime Minister in barely 3 years, and he's with us for a very special Christmas message this morning. But he's coming from, you're on the road, you're going to open, finally, State Highway 25A. Prime Minister, good morning.
Well, good morning, Ryan. I had to dial in on your last day.
Nice one. All right, well, thank you very much for joining us. We really do appreciate it. Merry Christmas to you, to Amanda, and to your family. And thank you for being on our show every week this year. We have very much appreciated your time.
Well, can I just say to you, thank you for what you do, holding everyone to account, me included. Thank you for not interviewing me standing up, because it would be like interviewing a hobbit, and I've appreciated that. But to all your viewers, can I just say, have a great Christmas, refresh, recharge, enjoy time with your loved ones, make some new memories, and gear up for a great 2024. Take care.
Take care. All right, ka kite. That is Prime Minister Christopher Luxon. It's 7:15. Now we're going to our political panel. We're joined this morning by Labor's Jenny Anderson. How many times have I done this? I'm struggling. National Minister Erica Stanford and Labor MP Jenny Anderson. Morena, good morning.
Morena, good morning.
Can we start with Kelvin Davis? We're just hearing news that he's bowing out of politics.
He is, yeah. It's really sad to lose Kelvin. He's been a real asset to our team. And personally, he's a good mate, so I'll be really sad to see him go.
Glad we cleared that up. That made the media in Australia, you know.
Yeah, I know. I know. I had a lot of messages from a lot of weird places.
So that is the background to your gift, Erica. And Jenny, your police portfolio is the background to your gift.
Thank you. Yeah. And I've got
to open them now.
Yes, please. Oh, yes.
Okay. Good. Well, being from the Hutt Valley, I thought I'd give you something that you can remember the Hutt Valley by.
Thank you.
And you could maybe
always love a memento from the Hutt Valley.
Is it something to do with cars or, like, boy races?
It says you must please the leader, our education minister, and then our former police minister in the handcuffs.
Fluffy handcuffs.
Yeah, we thought we'd give you the fluffy ones
kind,
at least.
The fun kind, yeah.
I love that.
So it won the best slogan and the worst slogan, I think.
That is cool.
Nice one, thank you.
Right, so I've got some as well.
Now, expecting you're now in government, so you've got just had a salary bump. I'm expecting something bougie here.
Well, this one I'm going to give to you first because it requires some application. You'll remember last year we had the man bun.
Yeah.
So this is going to take a little while. So these are some ornaments for your beard. So you could put them on now, I thought would be great. I have never thought so long and hard about the length of your beard here than I have in the last week, hoping that these will fit okay.
Ooh. So it's not long at the moment.
I know, well, I'm sure we can make it work. So while you work on that...
Suggesting the chest here might work.
Oh, yeah.
Since you've got it out today.
One in the beard, come on. And then, Mel, in keeping with last year...
Hers is not so long.
In keeping with last year...
Oh, yes.
Nice! That's exactly what I was hoping for. Christmas balls.
Nice.
Hey, what I was hoping to do was also get some presents for your children, like last year.
Aww,
and it's always a great friend who buys you musical presents for your children over Christmas.
Oh, no.
So firstly, hopefully Busby can become an excellent bassoon player like I was. And I started with the recorder, so that's for him.
Wonderful.
Because that's going to be amazing for you.
He once had a recorder and he put it down the toilet. So I got rid of it. So it's wonderful to have another one.
And this is for wee Mabel. If you want to hit it now, you can, but it goes off a lot. And it's very, very noisy. So
I will always think of you fondly, Erica, when I hear it.
Thank you so much.
And that's
so
kind, Erica.
Oh, that's nice.
Yep.
Guys, thank you so much. Oh, are we not
going?
All right,
sorry.
We do have ad breaks.
In keeping. Look.
Yeah.
functional, useful, everyday use. If anyone ever says that you are soft on crime again, you whip these out. How serious you are. I mean, they're a little bit soft.
Yeah, so. And they're red too. That's fantastic.
Okay, you can hang those up in your office.
Well, I thought, considering you were reviewing the sex education guidelines, that you might need to sort of bone up a little bit. So I've got you some background information, read up a little bit.
That sounds scandalous. What is that?
Oh, nice. Wonderful.
Thank you
both again for your time. National Minister Erica Stanford and Labor MP Jenny Anderson.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much.
24 after 7 now. Coming up next, from wild winds, they move. From wild winds to clear blue skies, we find out what the weather is going to throw at us this holiday season. Stick around.
Welcome back. You're watching AM on this Christmas special. Thanks for being with us. Now, last summer was a bit of a shocker for many of us around the country. To give us an idea of what's in store this Christmas, NIWA broadcaster Ben Noll is here with us for a quick check-in on how we are looking in the lead-up to Christmas. Ben, good morning. What's Christmas Day looking like? What can you predict at this stage?
Oh, going to the top.
26 away from 8. We are reflecting on the year that has been this year, and there have been many moments, serious and funny, but right now it's time to look at some of the lighter moments on AIM.
Could what we eat help protect ourselves from skin damage and premature ageing? One for you, Nikki. Thanks to our partners at Specsavers. We find out more next.
I'm going to be a thoroughbred horse.
But why?
Well, because I'm pure. Or not.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Cool. We're nearly at your polling result.
No, I'm just kidding.
Oh, that was a bit mean.
Sorry.
Jesus.
That was really low.
That was a bit of a low. That was a very low blow.
I'm sorry. I'm getting it out of my system now.
This plane to Barcelona, and it had to turn around 2 hours into the flight because of a biohazard on board. Now, it wasn't chemicals. It was poos. It was feces.
I don't know.
It must have been terrible, and everyone would have known it was you because you'd been covered in poo.
I would imagine where it would have gone. Up and down the aisle, and then the plane's taking off and landing, and it's dripping down. She had the two older ones on a leash each.
Mm. Oh, my mother used to have me on a leash.
Probably still should be. Is it a retractable one?
No, that wasn't retractable.
Like the poodles have walking down.
Poo bags attached.
Oopsie! Get that up!
He's running away. He's shitting on the ground.
Okay, let's get a trampoline in here one day. And,
let's not.
Take a look.
I'll wee my pants.
You walk down the street, your main street, wherever you...
Kimberly says, I had just started dating a bodybuilder who happened to have a huge...
10 minutes later.
Harley Davidson motorbike. You know what day you get sworn in?
I think things are happening next week, early next week.
Okay, so you are being sworn in. Nice to know. Thank you. No, you can't get on the train, you have to walk. And when you walk... This is a live shot of One Tree Hill, with more than one tree though, isn't there? That doesn't make any sense.
23 away from 8. Thanks for being with us for those moments this year. Up next, we check in with the Hawke's Bay mum of 5 who survived Cyclone Gabrielle, one of the more serious and very important moments on the show. Stay with us after the break. I'll be shooting that shot like 2K, girl. I know. Tell 'em I'm next. Tell 'em you follow. Keep this here for your annual nocturnal flight. Hoki Maiano, thanks for joining us on AM this morning. You are looking at the New Zealand Choral Academy. Thank you very much for being with us on this Christmas show this Friday morning. It's 19 minutes away from 8.
I like this one, 19 away from 8, as you say. And lots more of this to come, lots more Christmas surprises to come as well. But we got a surprise of a very unwelcome kind earlier in the year. Cyclone Gabrielle left a scar on the land and many people's lives. And you may remember she came on the show, I was down there with her, Dana Nuku. She's one of many survivors. The mother of five lost everything in the flood and was forced to bundle her kids up into the truck and drive through treacherous floodwaters to escape. Take a look. Yeah, it was a pretty heroic drive, and I remember Dana saying at the time she was just trying to keep calm and pretend it was an adventure, but it was a very dangerous situation that they were in. And can you believe it's almost a year on now, and we're checking in with this brave mum of five. Hawke's Bay resident Dana Nuku is with us, along with, I think we have Larry and Ruby.
Very cool. Coming up, we catch up with Patches, the celebrity cat who once weighed 19 kilos. Patches has been on a weight loss program, so how are things going? We'll find out soon. It's 10 away from 8. You're watching AM. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. Now, his weight loss journey has captured hearts
not
around
mine.
The world.
Not mine.
Well, you know. No, I'm only kidding. Patches the cat we're talking about was surrendered to a Virginian animal centre weighing just over 19 kilos, more than four times the recommended weight for cats. The last time we met him, he had just been adopted, and since then, he's been hard at work to drop those pounds. Patches joins us with his owner Kay Ford live from Virginia. Kay, lovely to see you. How are you doing?
I'm doing absolutely great. And let's get Patches. It's always much more dramatic if he's introduced now. Come here, honey. Here we go. All right, here he is.
Wow. He has lost a little bit, hasn't he?
Okay, I don't want to be rude, but has he put on weight?
this is
so, what are we? 6 minutes away
not
from
not even having
o'clock.
The neck to do that.
Yeah, not even being able to. Yeah, it's quite sad, isn't it?
It's nice.
Anyway, stay with us. We are back with more surprises and some special guests on our Christmas special next. Welcome back to AM. It is great to have you with us. Just gone 2 minutes away from 8 o'clock, and we have a beautiful the New Zealand Children's Choral Academy choir with us this morning and have been doing a fantastic job.
Thank you so much.
Well done. Just before we get to the news at 8 o'clock, I just want to do a quick shout-out. Lots of feedback coming in, of course, and we will get to most of it today. If we don't get to it, we are going to read it after the show, I promise you that. But a quick shout-out this morning to Debs, who is watching from Nelson. Mama Debs, hope all is well with you, and Merry Christmas.
I do want to say, too, on the choir, they have a Give a Little page. It's called Sing Out to Support Our Children's Choral Academy. So if you're liking what you're hearing this morning, head along to that Give a Little page, because you will be able to support them in the way that they need. Look at them.
Lots of feedback coming in. Lots of lovely things. Shout out to Warren in Kaikoura, always watches AM. He's 70 today.
Happy birthday, Warren.
Happy birthday, Warren. Have a great day from your far north whānau. Dee says, you're so handsome and funny and professional. I don't know who they're talking about.
Send email and send it over. He just bolds the ones that have all these really nice things about him.
Nothing is bolded.
Can someone send something a little more, I don't know, realistic?
Balanced.
We have some very exciting things coming up this hour, though. We have some surprises. We have our final goodbye to Ryan, and we have some giveaways. So stay with us for that. But now, here's your news.
The very latest from Newshub. It is 8:04.
Thank you very much, Nikki. And thank you to all of you who are sending in Christmas messages this morning. Feedback at amshow.co.nz. We really do appreciate, not just today, but through the year, all of the feedback that you give us. It helps us feel connected to you so that we know what you're feeling about issues, what's on your mind, and we've really enjoyed your company and love connecting with you in that way. So thanks for that.
It also just is entertaining. Sometimes the news can be quite sad or the news can be quite serious, and so when you send all of your often filthy things into the email inbox, we love reading them, and even if they don't quite make it to air, we very much enjoy your company in the morning too.
We are heading back to William now, who has been out. He's been in a car this morning from Webb's auction, so we're going to see where he has been, but first let's take a look at weather. Thank you very much, Nikki. Now, the reason we haven't been able to check back in with William for a little while is because he's been very busy. And William, what is it you've been out and about doing?
Well, then, Maui, we're in Grayland. We've actually picked up a special guest here. She's been, look, here she is. She's been absolutely out of control. Young Fanny.
This is a surprise Ryan didn't know.
It's a little surprise, yeah.
You didn't know that we were actually going to be able to bring her in.
She was meant to be going to Wellington today, so I didn't think I was going to see her. Oh, bless. I don't.
She's having a little outing with William.
So I am a little bit worried about you putting her in that car, though, William. I'm not paying for anything.
Well, I've got to tell you, Ryan, she's really been utilising the poo bags. I've never used so many in 10 minutes.
Yeah, she knows how to fill those things up.
She's good.
Oh, well, this is a lovely surprise.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
It's a great surprise.
So Fanny will be making her way in to see
Did she just have her own tag come up? She had her own, what are those things called?
Like a little graphic saying what her name is.
Baseline.
We were going to see Fanny very soon. But first, let's take a look back on some of the fun that William has been involved with this year.
I'm going to give you a rub, mate.
Come on.
But first of all, I wanted to ask you, is that a cannon? Or are you just happy to see me, mate?
Of course, I'd like to show you.
Nice club. Little to the right, mate.
We're going to just go easy.
There it is.
Why do I have to do all my first time things on the show?
For a straw.
Can you please get that out of my face, Leo?
Yeah.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 1. Yeah!
AM
show!
Awesome.
Give everyone a wave at home there. Beautiful ladies, but... just got to get that into the bump.
We're looking for the blue and gold macaw. That's Pablo the parrot.
Pablo! Come on, my bubba guy.
Sorry.
Come on, bud.
You see, I will never be king. And you will never see the light of another day in you.
Look at this. I've just had it plated.
You've just got so much hair.
There it is.
I actually feel really light. It feels good. Woohoo! We did it.
It's been a big year for you, William, and every day you never fail to make us smile to boost the morale. thank you very much.
Well, you did that well, Mel, the morale.
Thanks.
You did that well.
Yeah, I've learnt from the best.
Yeah, thank you, William. We absolutely love you, and you do. You make us laugh every day, so thank you, and thanks for bringing Fanny in. I'm excited.
Yeah, well,
so
thank you
Fanny.
Very much. It's been an amazing year, eh? But we're due for a rest, I think. Look, hey, but you, hey,
all
come
right,
on.
All right, Fanny, come on. Go with William. We'll see you soon.
Yeah. Yes, we'll see you guys soon.
So cute.
Oh, cool. It's 9 away from 8. Not long till she'll be here in the studio with us. Up next, one is never enough, but is 24 too many. We meet the Wellingtonian who had to rent a hall to house her Christmas tree collection.
Wow.
Stay with us.
That's next level.
Ding dong, merry the sky is ringed with angels singing. Ooh.
Good morning, New Zealand. A merry, happy Christmas and happy holidays
and a happy
New Year to you as well. It is great to have you with us 14 minutes after 8 o'clock on your Friday morning. We're checking in with our reporters right now, right around the country. But first, let's take a look at some of their highlights and their many lowlights from throughout the year.
We're heading around. Don't know what that's about.
Well, Laura, first of all, can I just say I've known Olsen for about 5 years, and this week's the first I've heard about her being a Broncos supporter. So, absolute fake fan from Olsen.
Oh, we love them. Our three musketeers, and they're all here today, which is great news. And we're going to start with James, who's in Wellington with a crazy Christmas tree lady.
Morena Ryan, that's right. I'm at the Pine Haven Hall in Upper Hutt, and I thought my mum was pretty obsessed with Christmas with her three Christmas trees in her house. Come on down and check it out.
James, that is so cool. Thank you very much for all of your work this year, James. Mel and I, you're secretly our favourite. We love listening to you. We love listening to your crosses.
Faves.
You're very entertaining.
Ryan, and you say that to everyone.
I know.
He does.
I know. But I can have a different favourite every day. Anyway, thank you, James. We've loved having you on the show this year. And we're going to our other favourite, Emma Olsen, who's at the world's highest post shop.
Yeah, the world's highest post box up the Sky Tower in Auckland. It's my favourite time of the year, the festive season, and I feel like you're never too old to post off your Christmas wish list to Santa. So I've taken it upon myself today to get everyone's wishes. And so this year, Mel has wished for a summer with some actual sun. James, he wants a round the world ticket in business class and a year off. I feel you on that one. Ryan, he wants world peace. And Nikki, well, she wishes to be Benjamin Button because she wants to be able to see without glasses, hear without having to say pardon, and get out of bed without needing 20 seconds to stand up straight. And then mine, I was trying to think of what I wanted to wish for this year, and all the boys back in the office, they said, wish for a boyfriend ever. No one has time for that. So I think this year I just want to spend a summer with all my nearest and dearest. So let's post this off this year. Please, Santa, make it come true.
Well, your wish is granted. G'day, mate.
Are you supposed to be in San Fran?
Yeah, potentially, but we couldn't miss Ryan's last show or the Christmas party last night. So.
Christmas party? How was that?
No, it was pretty good. We had a good night, but it's good to be here for Ryan's last day, isn't it?
Yeah, do you have any last words for Ryan?
Oh, just thanks for being a good host and looking after us and giving us plenty of stick when we need it. So we're going to miss you heaps, but it's been bloody good.
Plenty of stick. We will miss you a lot, Ry. And, I mean, we'll probably tell it to you in 20 minutes' time when we see you in the studio. But, yeah, you've been amazing to us. As you said the other day, we're your little cherubs. And, yeah, we're really going to miss you. But, yeah, we'll tell you soon. So we'll see you back in studio.
Thank you, guys. That's very sweet. It's pronounced cherubs too, Emma. Not the first time I've had to fix her pronunciation. Won't be the last.
Oh, they will miss you.
Thank you, guys. Love you both. And we'll see you here soon. It's 21 after 8.
Heading back to William now, who has got a Christmas treat for someone this morning. Tell us more, William.
Yeah, morena Mel, we're still here in Greyland. Fanny's in the car unassisted, so hopefully she's been barking in the house down, so we've got to be aware of that. But we've found somebody down here, this lovely, amazing woman getting her barbershop ready, Taryn. Good morning, Taryn.
Good morning, William.
Lovely to meet you.
So nice to meet you.
Yeah, lovely to meet you. Well, Christmas is coming up and we've got a special surprise for you, but I want to know what you're up to for Christmas. What friends, whānau, loved ones, food?
All of the above. I spend every Christmas with my family and also with my best friends because a lot of their families aren't here, so they all come to my family's place. Yeah. We just have food, time together.
Oh, well, we all know where to go to, everyone out there, to head around to Taryn's, but we do have a gift for you, and there it is. Look at that.
A nice cup. Yeah. I need a new coffee mug.
Yeah, a nice cup, but have a look what's inside. There's a gift from us at AM. You're the only one who wanted to talk to me this morning, so...
Oh, my goodness. Really?
Yeah. Farmers have generously given us $150 worth of vouchers, so you can go and find yourself a nice, lovely gift, or you maybe want to give it to somebody else. So, Merry Christmas, Tazza. Lovely to meet you.
Thank you so much.
And what do you have here? Is this your barbershop?
This is actually my partner's barbershop.
Yeah, and that's my job. Come down and get a fade. Come down and get a fade. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Back to you guys in the studio.
Lovely. Love to give away some prizes and some giveaways on Christmas and prezzies. Right, it's 23 past 8. Up next, we're talking world peace and the best way to control the kids this festive season with our Friday panel. That's next.
Sing.
Adam. Welcome back to AM. It is 27 after 8. One of those children does not look like the others. And that is because...
Do you mean the one with the beard?
Hiding amongst the beautiful singing from the New Zealand Children's Choral Academy is one of our panellists who needs to come and take his seat over here.
Hey, Sam.
Hey, Sam.
Nice work. We can hear you. You're a very good singer.
Yeah.
Thank you very much. My name's Sam Smith. I've won 4 Grammys.
Sam, it is great to see you. Merry Christmas.
Thank you. Right back at you.
Welcome also to Nano Girl Michelle Dickinson, who is with us this morning, along with Whānau Order Agency Chair, Mere Pikaro Kawa Tate. Morena.
Morena, morena.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you for having us on your last show. That's nice that you picked us.
Exactly. Yeah.
3 favourites.
You went for the best. And is it true that you used to be in this choir?
No. lovely Elise there was the head of music at Westlake Girls while I was at Westlake Boys, so we've done many, many song things together throughout the years, and I was very surprised to see her there this morning and took my opportunity to, oh man, sing again, I love it!
Oh, great. Oh, that was very cool.
Very cool. Him.
Was he very good? Was a thumbs up or thumbs down?
Thumbs up.
Okay.
Thank you so much.
Hey, so this year, how do we feel? What are we asking? I don't even know. How do you feel about the year?
Yeah. Well, it's so lovely having you on the show. And we've got a little bit of food here. Do
there's
help
so
yourself.
Much food here.
New World have very kindly brought that in so that we can feast for the rest of the show and keep you.
Thank you, New World.
Fed.
Yeah.
Well, we actually have a cast of thousands here, who I think will help us get through some of this food a little later on. It's just gone 28 minutes away from 9 o'clock. That's Nana Girl Michelle Dickinson, Whānau Order Agency Chair Mere Pikaro Kawa Tate, comedian and singer Sam Smith. Right now, it is time for the latest news.
Yes, I'm not the comedian.
Time for news with Nikki.
Morena, it's 8 in the south.
Thanks very much, Nikki. It's 22 away from 9. Coming up, Auckland's Highfield Reserve is celebrating its newest member of the whānau this Christmas. Find out more next. Watching AM this morning. It's lovely to have you. And on the screen right now is my wee bubba Mabel. She's 7 months now. She's a lovely wee girl. She's watching from home this morning. It's also been a big year for my boy Busby. There he is. He's 4 now. And he had his graduation from his preschool not long ago.
And this is my little Mila Mo. She's my granddaughter. She's 14 months old now. I can't believe it. I remember when she was born, we were working on this show. She is a very, very determined young lady and very busy. So, as you can tell from that lovely... but she is a handful for her parents, but we absolutely adore her. Hello, little Mila.
She sounds wonderful. Like grandma. She sounds like grandma. Busy.
No,
busy. A handful.
Yeah. 17 away from 9 now. Thousands of years ago, it's said that Mary rode a donkey as she travelled to Bethlehem with Joseph. You may remember this time last year, we had Ryan milking a cow at this time. Well, this year, we thought we'd get a bit more Christmassy, and we've gone with a donkey instead, and we have gone to... the so-called, also, it's a lovely place to go. Highfield Reserve, if you're ever around the Snells Beach, Algiers area in North Auckland. That was Peter Karcher Birch. Sorry.
Very cool, very cool. And don't forget to create your own traditions at Christmas time, because things that remind you of loved ones, things that remind you of family members, make sure you do that this Christmas as well. Right, we're going back to William now, who's just arrived back in the studio with his special package. I think that means Fanny's here.
Yay! Oh, look, she's done so well. So she cute. Looks calm.
You've done a good job, Penny.
I'm glad he's holding her, because she would have ripped that leather to pieces inside the car.
So I just had to take the belt off.
Even wearing a little Santa outfit.
I gave her lots of kisses this morning before I left. We had a good little session in the
here we
couch
go.
Before I came into work this morning.
She's going to be so happy to see you. Oh,
she's so heavy. Hello. Aww. Here you go. Hey, Penny. Go to Daddy.
Hey.
Hello.
Well, while Ryan's having a cuddle, you might want to go and get the tissues ready because it is almost time to say goodbye to Ryan on the AM show. He'll still stick around on the channel, but we say goodbye to Ryan very soon, so stay with us for that.
Oh, she's off.
There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts. In this year, for your annual nocturnal flight, does it look like a go with the race to snow for bringing the goodies this night?
Hoki Maino, welcome back to AM. It's 9 away from 9 and we are coming into the closing moments of our show. Nearly time to say goodbye to you for the year. Nearly time to say goodbye to Ben. Fanny's saying hello to our reporters coming in. Oh, that's really lovely. We're also joined by some of our crew here who put the show together. They're the backbone of our show. Thank you, Mitch.
It's okay.
We couldn't do it without you guys. You guys are awesome. You make us look good.
Thank you guys.
The day, though, really belongs to you, Ryan. Your time on the AM show has taken you on quite a journey over many years, professionally and personally. And many people who watch talk about your skill and your tenacity in interviewing the politicians, which you are brilliant at. I understand why people say that, but working with you has shown me what strikes me really is actually your care for people, how much you really want to make a difference in people's lives, whether it's been from the people we've spoken to who have been affected by the floods and the cyclone this year, or there's people like Viren Smith who needed help with medical access and funds. You really champion those people, and that is a wonderful part of your personality that I'm so glad is still going to shine at 7 o'clock. I would like to say a few more words, but we're just going to look back over the last year, your year on AM in 2023.
Thanks, Mel. I'm seeing this for the first time as you are, and it looks like they're on the roof. Everyone I have spoken to is running on pure adrenaline. Everyone's about to burst into tears. You can see it in their eyes and you can hear it in their voice. I've spoken to people who have lost family members. One woman whose family member was crushed by a landslide. What you're looking at is search and rescue teams looking at this stage for potentially a body inside this vehicle. Were you scared?
I just didn't want my kids to be scared.
Our house was muddy, yes.
I know, but at least you guys are safe, eh?
Yep.
When you say you there was a point where you didn't want to continue with the relationship, why was that? What were you feeling?
I was feeling real inadequate, almost less of a man.
Was it too many different things or too many dumb things? You know, too many things that just didn't make any sense.
Are you a bully?
No, I'm not a bully.
This is getting just a little bit annoying, the not recall thing. Do you get so many complaints that you would not recall getting this?
No, I don't.
We have managed to raise $321,000. Good morning and welcome to Parliament's debating chamber. The tourism agency involved is Experience Regina. They included such phrases as, show us your Regina. Regina, vagina, who cares?
You're my favourite TV show in the world.
Stop it. Well, you're live on TV right now.
Who do you think you would vote for at this election?
Daddy.
Mama.
Mama and Dada.
You can't help yourself. Oh! Oh, my God. Ow. Stella, are we excited? Woohoo! Stella's live on the show next. Stay with us on AM.
Thank you both. Nice to talk to you. It's 8 o'clock.
That's the National Party leader and incoming Prime Minister, Christopher Hitchens. Luxon.
Oh, we've had some really good fun. We love you so much. You've been complaining, though. You've been complaining all week. Oh, I want a memento. I want something to take away with my name on it.
A cup or something.
Yeah,
cup.
Oh. Well, we actually have gone one better than a cup.
Oh.
We've gone with the best thing you could ever have your mug on. So if I can get... Liz, would you mind bringing this in? Of course we wouldn't let you go empty-handed, silly.
This is so cool.
And then,
you'll have to open it, though.
I hope this is AM show branded.
We'll excuse you for not opening the card first today. Time magazine.
That's actually very good.
That is good. That was also before early morning hours and carb loading in the afternoon from this year. Thank you, guys. That's very cool. And you know that'll be going on my wall. Thank you so much, everybody. I have absolutely loved this experience. I've actually written, you know, I hate reading long written things. I'm going to do it now because I didn't want to miss anybody out, even though I probably still will. Anyway, it has been, I think, about 5 years on this show and filling in for Duncan, who was here before me, and then the last 2.5 years as host here, much of it alongside Mel. My math says that that's 587 episodes, 1,761 hours of live television.
Wow.
And now it is all over, and what a ride it's been. We've covered wars, disasters, we've helped solve crimes on this show, we've done like some crazy stuff. We've been there for the cyclones, we've been there for the elections, we raised $500,000 for flood victims, and it has been a huge privilege. A few thank yous and a special mentions from me to my family, to my mum and my brother Sean for constantly being the butt of my jokes on the show and no chance to defend yourselves. To Viv for setting the news agenda with her texts every morning. To my partner, who has never wanted to be named, but I thought this morning, in the spirit of Chippy on election night, thank you, Fergie. That's Fergie with a Y. I love you. Thank you for making this all possible, and I can't wait to marry you this year. A huge round of applause for our studio crew, because these guys are the ones that make this show come to life. To our hair and makeup artists, to Josie, Danny, Bella, Maddie, Katie Pye, we love you. To our producers and to all of their families who make sacrifices. They do long days, they do early mornings, all of that kind of stuff. In particular, I wanted to thank, I'm going to have to do auto cue because I can't remember their names right now. Lucy Walker, Nancy Price-Milne, Olivia Wilson, Kerry Ennis, Pete Cronshaw and Claire Watson for your leadership, guys. Thank you. To Mark Richardson and Amanda Gillies, who I started with on the show way back when, to Warner Brothers Discovery, Glenn Kine and Sarah Bristow. Sarah, thank you for identifying great talent. I was your best hire.
Was.
I hope I've done you proud. And to all of our wonderful guests, our reporters, our contributors. Bernie, I miss you. Laura, I loved working with you. William, you started on weather. didn't last long on weather. But hey, I was thanks thinking about this. Mate. Anyone can read weather. There's only one William Waiirua. Nikki Styris, you're a true talent. You're hilarious, you're professional, and never boring. Michael, you were some welcome male company on the couch. Our audience loves you. To Emma, Mitch and James, keep at it, kids. And to Mel, thank you for being there. Thank you for being there from the beginning. Through babies and engagements, we didn't know how this was really going to turn out.
No.
We didn't know if people would like us, but I always trusted you, and you always had my back, and I think we've shown that together we were a great team. And that people like us, which is important. And I know that you're going to smash it next year, so best of luck for that. Also, a big thank you to Casper, Mabel and Busby. Thanks for letting me have your wife and your mum. Are we getting extra time here, or are we cutting?
No, you need to be quiet.
Nancy, or are we cutting here? To our incredible audience, without you, we wouldn't be here. We made it our mission every single day to wake up and to ask, what do you want to see? What question do you most want answered? And what news event do you need to see today? And I sincerely hope that we have done that justice. I sincerely hope that you have enjoyed watching us and listening to us each morning. I'm just overwhelmed, completely overwhelmed, and so grateful to be given the opportunity. And don't worry, it is only a see you soon. It is not a goodbye. It's a good morning, New Zealand. Have a fantastic day, and I'll see you next year at 7. Ka kite.